Namaste children, we are in a chapter that is separation of substances. So in this chapter, in our previous class, we studied first what is a matter and different forms of matter. Matter means anything which is having a mass, which can occupy space, and even it have a charge also, that are called matter. And matter can exist in two different forms: as a pure substances form and as a mixture form. So pure substances, no need to separate. But when you will see the mixtures, we can see of two different categories: homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. As it is a mixture, means formed by the combination of two or different substances together, chemically combined together or physically combined together. Now such a mixtures need to be separated so that you can get the pure substances, you can remove the unwanted particles from it. So we are doing the separation method. So separation is nothing but removal of substances from a mixture. Means a mixture is formed by the combination of two or more substances, and in that two or more substances, if you are removing separately one substance, another substance into two different groups, then you are saying it as a separation. And this separation method, it is very much important, because we are separating the substances so that we can get the useful components. The second one, we are separating the mixtures so that we can remove the harmful components, the unwanted things. Even we can separating the substances so that you can remove the impurities that are present in it. Last but not the least, we are separating the substances so that we can group the substances into different sizes. And we are separating the substances to even study betterly about the pure substances. So there are so many different uses of separation substances are there. Matter can exist in mixture form. So that mixtures, we are always trying to separate into their pure substance form so that we can get the useful substances, we can remove the harmful particles and the impurities that are present in it. Even we are separating the substances so that you can get the substances of different sizes, different shapes. And even we are following the separation methods so that we can get the knowledge about the pure substances, and we can study further in detail about the pure substances. Okay children, so these are the different uses of separation of substances. And in our day-to-day life, knowingly or unknowingly, we are following different separation methods. At first it starts from the tea filtering that your mother will do like this. This is the common separation filtering method. Like this, you will see the filtering of tea by your mother, where in this method she is trying to remove the unwanted particles from the tea, that is your tea leaves. So like this is just common method, I said. Like this, in our day-to-day life, we are using different separation methods that we don't know. From the sieving of flour onwards, that is also a method of separation. So in our today's class, we will learn about different separation methods. So if you will see the separation methods, you can understand that we can separate two solid substances together, that is solid-solid separation. You can separate a solid and a liquid together, that is your solid-liquid separation. You can separate a liquid-liquid together, liquid-liquid separation. Like this, different separation methods are there. So basically, what is meant by separation? Separation means it is a process in which one substance is separated from the other in a mixture. So separation is done for the mixtures where one substance is separated from the other in a mixture. that particular process we are calling it as a separation. Okay, so now like here you can see different separation methods. Your mother, she will try to separate the food grains that are present in the rice, or the try to separate the stones, okay, that are present in the food grains. That is one type of different separation method. Yes, so like this you can see different varieties of separation methods where substance is separated from the other substance in a mixture. Okay, so this is one first basic method of separation, that is called your hand picking. What we are calling this method of separation, it's called your hand picking method. So in this hand picking method, you can see the solid separation, because rice grains are solids, or your dal is a solid, and your stones are also solid. So based on the color and the size, here the stones are separated by the hands. So we are calling this method as a hand picking method. Yes children, like this. So a first separation method where two solid substances are present and the stones are removed or separated from the food grains, that is your hand picking method. So the next method, this is also the common method you will observe at your houses, where your mother will start sieving the flour. So your mother, she is sieving the flour so that she can separate the husk that is present in the flour. Both are solids and she is trying to separate the husk from the flour. So this is another common method where two solid particles are separated. General life, in our day to day life, we will see this separation of husk from the flour. It is also a specialized method that is called sieving method, where a small fine pores of sieve, it is used to sieve the flour. Okay children, so now see here another method which generally you will see in the agricultural lands or some other areas, where the bundles of paddies are rubbed or beaten on the stones. This method we are saying as a threshing method. So here, due to the heaviness of the rice grains, that rice grains will get separated from the paddy. Yes, this method we are calling as a threshing method. Another method is there. This is your another method of separation, where again the solid, even either a threshing or this is called winnowing. So you are what, separating the heavy and lighter particles with the help of wind. So it is called your winnowing. So with the help of such a plate like structure, if you will start rinsing, or if you are start this winnowing method, all the lighter particles, they will fly away along with the wind, and the heavier particles will remain in the plate. So this particular method we are saying as a winnowing method, where again two solid substances, based on their weights, they are getting separated. So here today we had seen four different types of methods. One is the basic method, your hand picking method. The second one is sieving method. Third one is threshing method, and the fourth one is winnowing method. So these four methods that are based on the size, based on the color, based on their weight or density, they are totally separated from each other. Understand children? So now let us see some sieving methods that we'll observe other than for this flour. This method of sieving also we will observe while constructing our houses. From the sand, the bigger stones that are separated by the help of a sieve. So sieving method, not only in our kitchens, even it is useful while construction purpose also. Yes, this is a method that is threshing method, where the paddy bundles are beaten on the rocks or on the bundles, so that the paddy grains will fall down and they can farmers can collect the paddy grains. This method we are calling it as a threshing method. Okay children, in our today's class we learnt about different separation methods between solids and solids, solid to solids. Okay children, in our next class we are going to learn about the separation methods that are involved in solids and liquids and liquids and liquids. Okay children, thank you so much.